Walk along with me. This is what it is like to enter into the increasingly darker and darker spot known as Tunnel 6, located under the road to the Sugar Bowl Ski Resort. This tunnel is a symbol of the original race to build a railroad over Donner Summit, and a testament to the work of Chinese workers more than 150 years ago. Completed in 1866, this tunnel, carved out of solid granite, was the largest project of its kind ever attempted in the United States at the time. This tunnel, at 1,659 feet long, is the longest of the 15 tunnels that compose the Sierra Crossing, which brings us to the experience of those who built it. According to the Donner Summit Historical Society, Chinese workers worked in teams 24 hours a day, 6 days a week, wielding 18-pound sledgehammers. Their progress was measured in just inches per day. And then there's the lack of light. Imagine this, that at the time, some of those workers would go days without seeing anything but that little fleck of light at the end of the tunnel. That's because workers also had to deal with tunneling through snow dozens of feet high in winter to get to sheds like this one for sleep. Almost immediately, the completion of this tunnel would create the other notable spot adjacent to Tunnel 6, the Summit Hotels. First built in 1870 along the old Highway 40, the original hotel would be called the Cardwell House. It was home to 78 bedrooms, a ladies' parlor, and a saloon. But it would burn down in 1902. An even bigger new Summit Hotel would be built to replace it with accommodations for more than 300 guests. A newspaper clipping at the time would say, quote, "No better resort than this can be found in the world, as air is always pure and invigorating." But this hotel, it too, would burn down and not be rebuilt. So if you come to see Tunnel 6 in person, remember those who toiled in the dark to create it, and the hotels that were once considered the gem of the world. Tunnel 6, off Donner Summit Road.